is going to have to focus the entire race distance today to get out of here with the best finish they can. He's done that. Stay points in both stages inside
all
the
right,
top 10.
Everybody, we got three laps to go. We're going to walk through Glen, Byron, and Hendrick.
Glen has just done everything right to hit his marks, not make mistakes. They run 12th right now. This is well on track to be his best career effort at Watkins Glen.
Well, and the best thing that Bubba Wallace can hope for right now, even though he's having a great run, is for someone who has won already to win. And that's what William Reinhardt is doing, which means that it doesn't knock him out of that 16th fight in the playoffs. So Bubba Wallace, although he can't win, or potentially can't win with the run that we're seeing out of William Byron, it's going to be end up being a good points day for that team.
From Rashford Lasky right here thinking the same thing. If Byron can just go on and win this race, then both Kevin Lasky and Harvick partner are going to think, we're locked in, we're into the playoffs, Sire will leave, we're going to be coming to our meeting, Byron will be good with 6 of 10 left. Oh yeah, Ryan Kay and Kevin Harvick both, they are really going this thing to go three, two to go. William Byron, you're just controlling this field. He's been so impressive today. You know, think about his last few races, they've not been good, but 4 wins over the year, that's more than everybody else.
Great point. If William Byron does end up winning this race, Kevin Harvick, Keselowski both can lock themselves into the playoffs. So William Byron now under 2 laps to go.
Yeah, we talk about, you know, need to reestablish himself in the hunt for the championship. It's only been 5 races since that last win. He's won more stages than any other driver, 8 after today's race. And he's got more playoff points than any other car. As we're heading toward the playoffs, this car here is looking really good. Winning on the road course would be a great, great statement. And historically, this team's not been good in the summer. They run really well early and late. That was one of their goals, was to fix that. And it started to trend back the wrong way over the last month and a half.
No, today,
one more lap, they can move to the world, they can win the championship.
One lap to go, presented by Credit One Bank. William Byron, a little under 2.4 miles away from his first road course win as he makes his way through one and headed toward Eubanks in the essence.
What a painting of a flex for William Byron, Rudy Fugel, that 2014 Hendrick Motorsports. Up for the essence for the final time, he'll cross over the tunnel, exit out on the turn 4 and the back straightaway. William Byron headed to victory lane. No traffic ahead. We'll have to deal with a single car all the way back to the start-finish line to finish this one out. Easing through the bus stop for the final time. No mistakes. Not aggressive on the curve. Late downshift. Doing everything he can just to be smooth and perfect on this final lap. 5 wins in a row, man. Motorsports are locking it in. If he can make it to this last quarter of the racetrack, and not only 5 in a row for Hendrick, but a call field. I'm ready for the championship.
Fifth consecutive.
Comes up on the
Walking Glen Game Motorsports is going to win here at the Glen. William Byron, fifth win of the season.
Fighting for the 19th position. Yeah, we'll have to see if there's something going on earlier in the lap, because I believe
course racing.
Second race in a row.
Jeff Gordon. He was the last one to take the 24 victory lane at Watkins Glen. He did it four times here.
Well, you just got to survive Daytona. And since we have a repeat winner, Harvick and Kozlowski are locked into the playoffs now. Six laps, so he went all but 24. That isn't a masterclass to anyone, then I don't know what it is. He's burn it. Well, Daytona is going to be crazy, that's for sure. Wow, what a burnout. Well, onto Daytona, that's going to be crazy.